Ever wonder what the differences are between the Boeing 737-900 and the 737-900ER? Well, the ER part of it might give it away, if you know what those letters stand for. But there's actually more to the story. Let's look at how the jets are built differently in today's video. The Boeing 737-900 was born in April 1997 to compete with the 185-220-seat Airbus A321. This variant featured a 7-foot 10-inch fuselage extension, giving it an overall length of 138 feet and 3 inches, longer than the Boeing 707-120. The 900 has 9% more cabin floor space and 18% more cargo space than the Dash 800. However, Boeing opted to use the same NG emergency exit layout with 4 main exit doors and 4 overwing exits. This means the maximum passenger load is still 189. The Dash 900 would not be very popular, with only 52 orders. The limited additional seating meant airlines had little incentive to switch to the 737-900 from the Dash 800, as it only seated about a dozen more passengers at best. Meanwhile, the A321-200 could carry 200 to 220 passengers. However, Boeing was not calling it quits and sought to upgrade the 737-900 to make it more competitive. The Dash 900ER was created by adding capacity for up to 215 passengers in one class seating. This variant added a pair of Type 2 doors aft of the wing for passenger evacuation regulations and installing a new flattened aft pressure bulkhead, which would add an extra fuselage frame of cabin space, approximately one row of seats. The flat bulkhead became standard on all 737s from 2006, and the Type 2 door also became standard on all Series 900s, although operators could choose to have it deactivated. The Dash 900ER's range was increased with the addition of 2 1,970-litre or 520-gallon auxiliary fuel tanks. This meant the aircraft could fly up to 3,200 nautical miles or 2,800 nautical miles without optional winglets. The jet also had reinforced landing gear legs, wing box and keel beam structure to handle the increased maximum takeoff weight of 187,700 pounds. The Dash 900ER, according to chaviation.com, won 505 orders. This popularity underscored the demand from airlines for higher capacity single-aisle jets. Even with more weight than the base Dash 900, the Dash 900ER has more range and is more efficient when it comes to fuel burn per passenger. It's also interesting that the 737-900ER was intended to be an attempt to replace the Boeing 757-200 in a 737 package. And even though major customer Alaska Airlines never operated 757s, the airline would use its order of 737-900ERs to replace its little 737-400s to gain more capacity, efficiency, and range. Have you flown on the relatively rare 737-900? Or how about the more common 737-900ER? Share your experiences with us by leaving a comment. In addition to our daily YouTube videos, Simple Flying publishes over 150 articles every week. If you're looking for the latest aviation news and insights, visit simpleflying.com.